Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBM I, RPG and SQL sample video. Today we're diving into the world of OLAP functions in SQL, running on IBM I using DB2 for I. These functions let us do advanced analytics directly in SQL without writing loops or temporary tables. And they work great in ACS, DB2 for I, and inside embedded SQL in RPG. Let's explore them with real simple examples. Let's go. OLAP stands for Online Analytical Processing. In SQL, OLAP functions are part of the window function family. They allow you to compute values across related rows of your query result while still keeping each individual row. Then you group or reduce rows like group by. Instead, they give you per row calculations based on a window of data. These functions are great for reporting and are especially useful when you want to, for example, rank results, compare rows, previous or next, get cumulative totals, identify first and last values, split data into buckets, etc. For making it easier, let's do it with a simple data set. Let's create a simple table to test with. Create the table. We're gonna create a table that is gonna be sales. And we're gonna have these fields. Identity. Customer. Product, a date, and an amount. Okay, so we're gonna have this table. Okay, we don't have any information inside, and let me insert some data inside the table. I have some data prepared in another screen, so let me do it. Okay, so we have all this information inside the table. Okay, we got 8 sales ID with different customers, different products, different sale dates, and different amounts, okay? Well, let's talk about rank. With rank, we can assign a position number to each row based on the order of a specific column. If two or more rows have the same value, they receive the same rank, and the next is skipped. Okay, let's make an example. We want to know the top sales per customer. Okay, if you see this this table, we want to get the top sales per customer. Okay, so for that we can do something like this. We're going to have ranked sales as, this is going to be a temporary table. Okay, select customer, product, amount, and also we want to get the rank. The rank, what is the rank? Well, rank is defined as this: rank over, and let's make a partition of my data by customer, order by amount, desk sending. Okay, and this is gonna be the ranking. Okay, so well, of course, all this is from my table. Okay. Well, imagine that I want to get all the ranking. So I can do something like this: from ranked sales. Okay. So I'm doing with ranked sales as this. We want to know everything from this table. Okay. So this is what I'm getting. We get Alice, Bob, Carl, okay, the three customers, And this is the ranking of the product that has more sales. Okay, the product number one and three for Alice is ranked with the number one. See that there is no number two, okay? Because with this function, they rank, if there are two or more rows with the same value, they receive the same rank, and the next is skipped, okay? The same happens with Bob, okay? And with Carl, okay? With because the amount is the same, okay? Well, imagine that we don't want to use gaps when using rank, okay? Then we will need to use a different function. We will see it later, okay? But imagine that we want to get, for example, the products with the rank with the rank one, okay? Well, in that case, we can do something like this, where ranking is equal to one, okay? And then we will get this, okay? We can make a select over this temporary table without problems, okay? Imagine that we want not to use gaps, okay? As I said before, then we can use a different function that is dense rank, okay? For example, imagine that we want to get customer product amount, okay? And now we want the rank that is gonna be dense rank over a partition by customer order by amount desk. It is the same, okay? And this is gonna be as dense rank, okay? Ranking, okay? Of course, from my table that is sales, okay? These two things are the same, but we are doing it directly without the temporary table, okay? And this way, what we are getting is this, okay? We have the same as before, but now in this case we don't have a three, we have a two, okay? And this in this case is the same, okay? Well, I think these two functions are very useful. Well, let's now talk about NTILE. NTILE is an SQL function that splits your result set into n equal or nearly equal groups called tiles or buckets. Is it useful for divide data into percentiles, for example? Let me show it as an example because I think it is better. Imagine that I want to do something like this. Select customer, product, amount, and we want the entile 2 over partition by customer order by amount desk as bucket, okay, for example. And this is gonna be from my table sales, okay? And this is what I get. Okay, we're getting these two are in the bucket number one, this is in the bucket number two, okay? Let's talk now about sum over, okay? Well, sum over, with sum over, we can make a sum of groups of data returning it in a single result. For example, if we want to know totals of sales per customer over time, we can do something like this. For example, we can do select customer, sale date, amount, and then we want to get the sum of the amount, but over a partition that is gonna be by customer, order by amount, a sale date, rows between unbounded, presenting, and current row. For example, and this is gonna be from my table sales. Well, this is what I get. as you see, in the case of this customer Alice, what we are getting is the amount, okay, for every sale, but we're getting in this field, in this column, what we're getting is the running total. Okay, so we got 300. Now we have 150 more, that is 450, 300 more, that is 750. Okay, and now we are starting again with the next customer. Okay, 100, 300, 500, and now again starting with Carl with 400 and 400 more, that is 800. Okay, well, this is, I think, very useful for making different analytics over data. Okay, well, now let's talk about first value. Okay, first value is a function that we can use for getting the first value in a specific column based on the order defined by the order by clause in your query. Okay, well, let's create this query: customer, sale date, amount, and we want the first value of the amount over partition by customer, order by sale date as first day, first sale. Okay, and this is gonna be from my table sales. What I get is this. Oh, this is this way. Okay, well, this gives us the first sale amount for each customer, okay, repeated on each row. Okay, so for example, for Alice, the first sale was 300 and it is repeated in every row of this customer. Okay, the same in Bob and the same in Carl. Okay, well, now we are going to talk about lag. With lag, we can compare with the previous value. We can say that lag let us look backward. Okay, let's see it with an example. Okay, imagine that we want to compare a sale with the one before it for the same customer. Okay, well, let me do it again with this temporary table, lag sales as select customer, sale date, amount, and we want the lag over amount one over partition by customer, order by sale date, as previous amount. Okay, and all this from sales. And from this temporary table, what we are going to get is select customer, sale date, amount, previous amount, and we want amount minus okay well, this is what I'm getting. It is a little hard to understand, but well, seeing it with an example is simple. Okay, what we are getting is for the customer Alice, we get 300 of the amount of the sale. Okay, the previous amount was null because there wasn't a previous amount, and the difference is this. Okay, I'm calculating a difference between the previous and the amount. Okay, and that is why I'm using coalesce, okay, because I can get a null. Okay, For Alice, again, 150, the previous amount was 300, and the difference of the 300 and 150 is minus 150, okay? And so on. So as you see, this is a very complex query that I'm making with just this query without using code or RPG code or something like that, okay? Directly using these functions, we are getting this information in a very easy way, okay? With lead, we can do the same, but comparing with the next row, okay? We can do the same as with black, but with the next row, okay? For example, let me create this example, okay? We can do something like this. Select customer, sale date, amount, and we want lead amount 1, okay, over partition by customer order by sale date as next amount, okay. Doing this, we are getting the next amount, okay, and lead amount 1 over partition by customer order by sale date minus amount, okay, amount as next diff, for example, okay, from sales. Okay, so see that we are doing the same as before, okay, but in a different way. Okay, we got Alice that is that has this date. We got a sale of 300 of amount of 300, and we are writing here the next amount that is gonna be 150 and the difference. Okay, what will happen when we are reading the last record? Well, in that case, we are getting null in the next amount, and the difference is gonna be null. Okay. Well, the same for the rest of the customers, okay? So basically what we are doing is comparing a sale with the next one, okay? And this can be very useful, for example, for detecting rising or falling trends, okay? So in this video, we have been talking about OLAP functions in SQL on IBM i. We have talked about rank and dense rank. We have been talking about NTILE, sum over, lag and lead, and first value, but of course there are more OLAP functions available. As I told you before, you can run all these examples using ACS, DB2 for i, like me, or you can use them in embedded SQL inside RPG programs for powerful logic and analytics right inside your business apps. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. Try playing with these functions in your own data sets. You'll be surprised how much they can do. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.